Hello everyone, it's Phil here doing another video. In this video I'm gonna review a little fan controller. Very cheap, got this off eBay. $199 US, so it was just over $2 Australian. And this is what the box looks like. So let's have a look. Actually, I'm gonna use this one because there's no stick in the way. Let's say auto speed controller. Spec rally for super silent cooling. It's probably specifically or specially for what have we got at the back? Some model numbers. RPM alert. Okay, so it features an RPM alert. Controls the voltage from 5 to 12 volts. It's got 12 watts power rating. Manual adjust the fan speed. Suitable for high RPM fans. Stop working alarm. So it draws up the current of 1 amp. And some dimensions. Yeah. Now the RPM alert thingy, I was not able to get that going. Well, it doesn't really explain what it's meant to do. There's no instructions really. But when I manually stopped the fan, I didn't get any alarm. Okay, so what's in the box? This double-sided tape, which allows you to sticky tape this thing to somewhere else. So this is where your CPU cooler goes, and this goes to your motherboard. So pretty straightforward stuff. And there's a little wheel on here. I think it's actually labeled minus this. So if you turn it anti-clockwise, it should slow down. If you turn it clockwise, it should speed up. Okay, so I'm gonna hook it up to my motherboard, and we're gonna have a quick play around and see if it works. Okay, here we are on the motherboard. It's a Pentium 3 1.1 gigahertz on a open slot 1 motherboard. For some reason the CPU header stopped working, so I'm just using this one over here. And this is the copper Pentium 3 StarTech cooler I reviewed a while ago. So I'm just gonna turn it on. We're gonna have a listen how loud this thing is. Okay, so I'm just gonna hook up the adapter. I'm trying to do this with one hand, so basically this goes in here, and then we're just gonna hook up. There you have it. Alrighty, so let's turn it to the maximum, which is clockwise. There we go, and now we should be able to adjust the RPM. Just gonna turn it back and forth so we can hear the difference. Oops, yep, don't try this at home. So yeah, that's working pretty well. So I'm just gonna try another cooler. Okay, here we go. So I've got this cooler attached. Actually, not quite sure what it's called. Oh, there you go. Akua cooler. It's quite a big one, and it's got an RPM speed of up to 7,000. So, yes, it's very loud. Okay, so let's try the alarm function. There you go, that should do the trick. So yeah, it doesn't move, it's trying its best. I can't really hear any alarm. So, not quite sure what the alarm function is about, but doesn't seem to do anything. Alrighty, and that's really the conclusion of the video. What do I think? Well, for the money, you cannot go wrong. It does exactly what it says it does. Not quite sure why they're talking about the alarm feature. I actually didn't even properly read the description. It was only when I starting to shoot this video that I checked it out. And yeah, it does what it's supposed to do. And if you fans in your retro computer are a little bit too loud, definitely worth buying. I usually, when I find something cheap on eBay that I like, I usually get a couple, because just in chance something is broken, which can happen with these cheap ones. But yeah, I recommend it. $1.99 in US dollars, can't go wrong. It does what it's supposed to do, and didn't have any issues using it.